With reflection mapping, we get sharp reflections. This is good as far as it goes, but many reflective surfaces are glossy. They're shiny, but they're not mirror-like. Reflections are a bit blurred. One way to simulate this effect is to blur the reflection map. This blurring is usually done in advance and the texture stored. Some cleverness is needed to properly filter from face to face of the cube map, but utilities exist that perform this function for you. Think about the Blinfong specular reflection model for a moment. Blinfong and other reflection models work by taking the light's direction and eye direction. They use these to decide at a point on a surface how much that point is likely to be a perfect mirror. Whatever portion is a mirror reflects this light. In reality, much of the world most of the time is sending photons to any given point in space from many different directions. Look around and everything you can see is sending light your way. It doesn't matter if the light is from an emitter or a surface, except that our emitters are usually brighter. What an environment map does is treats the whole surrounding world as a source of light. While blurring an environment map is not entirely physically correct, it is extremely convincing. There is less of a problem of a reflection not matching up with what's in the environment, since you can't see a clear reflection on a burnished surface. Another advantage is that these blurry cube maps can be considerably smaller in size and still look good. For the two cube maps I showed, the original had faces that were 512 by 512 texels in size, the blurred version only 128 by 128. A lower resolution is all that's needed since the color changes more slowly. If you want a wider range of materials, you can blur the original reflection map by different amounts and get different gloss textures. You can also mix and match between sharp and blurred reflections on the same surface, giving an impression of a multi-coat material. Combining these ideas with different reflectivities, illumination models, and surface colors can give a wide range of effects.